Supporters appreciating her efforts. She scored 17.1 in qualification. The D score of 8.6, the difficulty score. Here in slow motion, you see how intricate the work is, how complex the elements are. Beautiful smile across her face as she completes those rotations. She competed at the Rio Olympic Games, and there her score comes through 17.7. Our second finalist represents Belarus, Katerina Halkina, 20 years of age, an experienced international performer. Interesting and creative transitions there. Impressive work. Oh, impressive indeed. She has her own unique style she brings to the exercise. Multicoloured leotard to match a multicoloured personality. Certainly stamping some charisma on that routine. She was placed sixth all around in Rio, winner of the World Challenge Cup Series in 2017. Qualified into this final with a score of 17.25. Here we just see the coordination. Exquisite. Lovely touch. You see clearly those crystals embossed on the leotard. All of it part of the theatre and the art and the presentation of the exercise. The score comes through 17.6. Well, the Russian flags are flying high for our next performer. One of two family members in this final. Dina Avarina prepares for her hoop routine. Beautiful leaps. A rebound off the back leg there. Incredible difficulty. Well, well, well. Dramatic and rousing. Wave to the crowd, they seem to enjoy it. Back in March of 2016, she said her ambition was to compete at the World Championships. Well, she can tick that box. And who knows what she may come away with. Took a gold all around at the World Challenge Cup in Kazan. She also took a gold in the hoop, his apparatus and the clubs. She is the 2017 Russian all-around national champion. 19 years of age. Well, it was fast, it was mischievous, it was difficult. Made those skills look effortless. Scored 18.95 in qualification, a higher score, and then 19.1. 10 for difficulty, 9.1 for execution. A fantastic mark. Our next gymnast represents the United States of America. Only 16 years of age, it's Evita Briskenas. Thank you. That's a shame. She recovered well after the error in the middle, gaining experience at her first World Championships. Big smile at the judges at the end, didn't look too disappointed. Scored 17.3 in qualification. Being reassured by the coach. She competed at the World Challenge Cup earlier in the year where she was placed 15th all around and is the current hoop and ribbon champion for the United States of America. A light on her feet. Smooth in the transition. Rotations of the hoop around different parts of the body. Having to include body difficulties and apparatus difficulties. There, the score 15.75. So, there are the standings after the first four performers. Tina Avarina leading with 19.1. She has set the bar high. Now to perform and representing Israel, we have Ninoy Ashram. So clean in the execution of these very difficult elements. Exciting work. Artistry displayed by Ninoy Ashram. Dynamic gymnast. Adventurous in the skills that she put in that routine. And there's a slight error towards the end. Qualified with a second highest score of 18.6 and a difficulty of 9.8. She looks a little disappointed. She was the first gymnast from Israel to win a world gold medal with the clubs at the 2015 Grand Prix final. She also took a bronze with a hoop and clubs at the European Championships. Beautifully performed, Ponche turns there. Bank of cameramen there, all waiting to get the shot. And she's qualified for both finals. Really exciting prospect for the future. 18 years of age. Well, those young fans seem to be enjoying themselves. Perhaps they'll be hula hooping at home this evening. You see in the background the two huge Russian flags, with the image of the Averina twins. Look at that routine one more time. Lovely little rebound touch there. Such composure and competence. And of course, the artistry and expression. So important in rhythmic gymnastics. You have to balance his body movements, the technical difficulties with the apparatus, and of course artistry. The interpretation of the music is so important. It's been said many times before, but rhythmic gymnastics really is where sport meets art. That anxious wait for the score to come through. And there it is, 16.9. Unfortunately, that error was costly. Next to perform, representing Japan, Sumire Kita. Dramatic change in tempo in the music and movements to match. Thank you. Well, great composure from the 16-year-old. This is her first year as a senior competitor. Balletic in her approach to that routine. A promising youngster. She won a bronze ribbon in the Asian Games for her ribbon routine. Gaining experience at her first World Championships. Scored 17 marks exactly in qualification. So flexible. So well prepared. And the pivot in attitude. A difficulty score of 8.7 in qualification, only 8.2 there, giving her a score of 16.65. Places her in fifth at the moment. Now then, this gymnast is from Bulgaria, Leviana Vladinova. Three years of age, an experienced performer. Contemporary interpretation of the music. Lovely line. Well, clean me through for Leviana Vladinova from Bulgaria. Waves to the crowd. Enjoying her time here. She took up rhythmic gymnastics when she was just 5 years of age. And was placed seventh all around at the Rio Olympic Games last year. She won this piece of apparatus in Minsk at the World Challenge Cup. Such awareness in space where the hoop is whilst doing those body difficulty elements. Thank you. And the score comes through 17.55, which puts her into fourth place. And so we welcome into the arena the twin sister of Dina. This time it's Alina Averina from Russia. Again, another change in tempo. Demonstrating all of her skills with this apparatus. Hello, dramatic conclusion there to the exercise. And the Russian crowd enjoying that performance. Qualified with the third highest score of 18.35. Alina won 3 out of 4 golds at the World Games earlier in the year. The only one she missed out on was the clubs, where she took a bronze. Had to settle for a bronze while her sister won that event. But an exciting gymnast. And a colourful leotard to match the colourful performance. Assured, artistic, accurate. But what will it be rewarded with? Interesting transitions, very difficult. She has a spring in her step. Been supported here today by 3 times world champion Yana Kudryavtseva, who has now retired. Although we see there has been an inquiry submitted for Neviana Vladinova. So we'll not be able to confirm the results until that has been looked into. That can only be into the difficulty score rather than the execution score. So we have seen all of the exercises in this hoop final, but confirmation of the results still to come. Meanwhile, the anxious wait for her sister leads with 19.1, an incredible score. 17.6 for Kaho Minagawa. And Katerina Halkina of Belarus, currently in bronze medal position with 17.6. Okay, a replay of Neviana Vladinova from Bulgaria. Just 0.05 outside of the medals at the moment. But of course, we still have that score for Alina Averina to come in. The ball final still to come this evening. It's been a long day for some of these gymnasts. There were seven groups of qualification starting at 9 o'clock this morning. Well, the inquiry for Neviana Vladinova has been rejected, so the score stays the same, 17.55. So we just wait for the final result for Arina Averina. And there it is, 19 marks exactly. Her sister will take the title and she will settle for silver. So their confirmation of the results, Dina Averina wins the hoop final with 19.1. Arina Averina will take silver, Kaho Minagawa the bronze with 17.7. Exciting hoop final there, right to the close. The ball final is yet to come. So lots more action here at the Adriatic Arena in Pesaro. And here we have the start list for that ball final. Ninoy Ashram appears again. Alexandra Ajojugalese from Italy. The audience have seen her name appear and have responded appropriately. And Kawa Minagawa from Japan, third on that list. Eight gymnasts qualified. It is a random selection in terms of the order which they appear. And we're ready to move straight into that final in Ninoy Ashram. Traveling with ease and fluidity. Super work. Well, she faltered slightly in the hoop final, but she wanted to come back and impress. And she's certainly done so with her ball exercise. daring, dramatic. It's a wonderful gymnast to watch. Her transitions make her work very interesting. Impressive catch there as she's traveling backwards into the walkover. Very difficult to see and execute, but no problem there. High in the leap. Expressive with the arms. As we wait for the mark, the noise begins to build around the arena. There it is, 17.925 for Linoy Ashram. The Italian flags are flying high for our next competitor. They're raising the roof of the Adriatic Arena for Alexandra Acciaducalese. Beautiful. Transition from one shape to the next in the pivot. Graceful, composed, adventurous. This young 16-year-old has a great future ahead of her. Performed with such maturity and promise in a pressured environment. She certainly wanted to please the crowd, and that she did. First year as a senior, her first World Championships, performing to Hallelujah. Captivating performance from her. Controlling the line. Enjoying her time here. I want to remember, she scored 16.95 in qualification, and qualified with the seventh highest score, with a difficulty score of 8.3, possibly not as difficult as some of the others, but there she scored 17 marks exactly. She's pleased with that, and rightly so. And now we welcome back into the arena Kaho Minagawa from Japan. We've already seen her earn a bronze medal with the hoop. How will she fare with the ball? Well, a slight stumble just towards the end of that routine. I tried to mask it well. She scored 16.9 in qualification with a difficulty score of 8.5. And the words in that particular piece of music. Voice can be used as an instrument and words can be used for up to two of the individual routines, but it has to be submitted beforehand. It gives the gymnast a great variety of exercises to look at, or tunes and music to use. Let's take a look again at the exercise. Beautiful in the split position in the leap. And they're assured in the catch. The talent is breathtaking. These gymnasts, what they're able to do with the hand apparatus. And the score 16.3 for Kaho Minagawa. So our fourth finalist from Bulgaria is Neviana Vladinova. Fifth with the hoop. Can she improve on that here with the ball? controlled in the fouettés. Nice work. Interesting combination and a lovely finish to the routine. Clever ways of using the apparatus. The ball, of course, can never be held, be balanced, but has to be continuously rolled and moved. Fluidity between the body and the apparatus. The gymnast and the ball become one. Working unity. Well, she made her international debut for Bulgaria back in 2011. And here, trapping the ball behind her. Very accurate. And there. Difficult work, made to look so effortless by these international performers. And the score comes through, 17.95 is the highest score so far. Puts her in the lead at the halfway point. Improved on qualification. There we have it. There's 0.025 ahead of Linoy Ashram. And we're ready for our fifth performer representing the United States of America. And this is Laura Zeng. Clever utilization and transitions between grips of her feet. Laura Zeng, 17 years of age, she'll be 18 in October. Qualified with a score of 17 marks exactly. And a difficulty score of 8.4. She trains hard in the United States of America, but has a trip every 2 or 3 months over to Moscow to receive some guidance from Arina Viner, Russian coach, steeped in tradition and excellence in this discipline of gymnastics. Thank you. Nora is the 2015 all-round Pan-American champion and was placed 11th in Rio Olympic Games. Took a bronze in the all-around competition at the Youth Olympic Games back in 2014. And the score comes through 17.05. It puts her in third place so far. It's improved on her qualification score by 0.05. Three more gymnasts to perform, and amongst them we have Arena Twins. Our Russian contingent know they are due to perform any moment. And here we are, Arena Avarina, silver medal with the hoop, pipped by her identical twin sister. She's back with the ball. Can she go one better? Beautiful. Technically excellent. She's really selling it to the crowd. Now she's pleased with that performance. A mischievous and effervescent routine. Packed with difficulty. You could tell by her finishing pose that she was pleased with that one. Greeted by her coach and appreciating the support from everyone here in Pesaro. Scored 18.575 in qualification with a difficulty score of 9.5. Cheeky expression on her face. Extended in the leaps. And a cheeky little rebound. Elfin-like qualities in that routine. And the score, 18.95. She's improved on qualification. Goes into the lead with two more gymnasts to go. And she's followed into the arena by her twin sister, Dina Avarina. She already has one world title under her belt. Can she focus her attention and repeat her performance with the ball? If she wanted to gain local support, this is the way to do it. Perform your routine to Volare. What an expression at the end. I don't know who enjoyed that more, Dina or our Italian crowd. Well, she can be satisfied with her work today. A job well done. She scored 18.85 in qualification. But she's going to have to improve on that if she's to beat her sister. Smiles all round. Let's take a look at her in action one more time. Slow motion really does show just how intricate the movements are. Often unsighted when they're re-catching the ball. And the score comes through 18.7 into second place at the moment with one more gymnast to go. So Arena Avarina leads Dina Avarina in silver medal at the moment. And in the bronze with 17.95 is Naviana Vladinova from Bulgaria. One more gymnast between them and the medals. And she represents Belarus. It's Katerina Halkina. A very focused and determined look upon her face. She begins her exercise. beautiful spin high in releve. Combination of skills there. Well, graceful, considered, artistic. Is it enough? She's called 17.35 in qualification. Took a bronze medal with the hoop at the Sofia World Cup. Now 20 years of age. Classical performance from her. Utilising the ball to its maximum. Catches the rolls on different body parts. Looking for a score of 17.95 or over to get in amongst the medals. Oh, just below 17.8. That puts her into fifth place in this final. So, disappointment that she's out of the medals. Here, confirmation of the results. Taking the world title with the ball. Arina Averino with 18.95. Dina Averino will win the silver with 18.7. And the bronze medal goes to Neviana Vladinova with 17.95. And the mascot entertaining people in the crowd whilst they wait for the medal ceremony. It has been a long but a fruitful day. Qualification with the hoop and ball happened this morning, not just for the finals this evening, but those scores will also go towards the all-around competition. It will continue tomorrow with clubs and ribbon. The finals for those two tomorrow evening. Followed by the all-around individual. And as we get into the weekend, we see our groups come into action. Exciting times ahead. We've seen that Katerina Halkina has submitted an inquiry, so just as we think it's over, because she is the final performer, she is able to do so. They have to do it before the next one, or certainly within an allotted time. It has to be shortly after the performance, and she is entitled to do so. So we'll see her performing one more time. Such extension in the ankles. Years of training and preparation to gain the body conditioning and flexibility required to be a rhythmic performer at this level. Judges looking over the routine one more time. confirming the difficulty score. Meanwhile, the crowd wait for the victory ceremony. Well, they're certainly not tired. It may have been a long day, but they've got bundles of energy. Meanwhile, the inquiry has been rejected for Katerina Halkina, so the scores stand. She remains with a score of 17.8 for her ball exercise. Looking back at the highlights of that ball routine from Niviana Vladinova. So expressive. There was her score, 17.95, earning her the bronze medal. Here, Dina Avarina. Performing to Volare, the crowd were on their feet, clapping along. It's been a successful day for the Avarina twins. Here, the title won by Arena Avarina, 18.95. So the gymnastic action is over. All that remains is for the victory ceremony for the individual hoop and ball finals. So the first of our eight world victory ceremonies. And the bronze medal going to Kaho Minagawa from Japan. Putting a fine performance to win the bronze, she'll be thrilled with that. Arina Avarina from the Russian Federation wins the silver. be some large trophy cabinet at home for this family. Dina Everina wins the world title and gold medal with the hoop. Gymnast being congratulated by the presentation party. The all important photo being taken for the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and honor the national anthem.
The mascot presenting the medalists with a souvenir to go along with the medals. Well, that just about concludes all of the action here at the Adriatic Arena as we come to the end of day one of the 35th World Rhythmic Gymnastics Championships. We hope you've enjoyed joining us. Please do join us again tomorrow when we'll feature the clubs and the ribbon. Well, I do apologise. We've got the ball final to come before we leave you and bid you farewell. Presentation party assembling for the victory ceremony. Of course, our Averina twins. We'll need to make their way back and assemble for the next presentation. Give them a moment to do that. And it looks like we're just about ready to welcome them back in.
Terza classificata, medaglia di bronzo, Mediana Vladimova.
And the bronze medal goes to Neviana Vladinova from Bulgaria.
Seconda classificata,
and this time it's a silver medal for Dina Averina. We'll see. Earning her 18.7.
Prima classificata, medaglia d'oro, campionessa del mondo con la palla, Arina Avena, Russia.
So the world title, champion with the ball, by Arina Averina, takes the gold medal. 18.95 was the score for her ball routine. Excellent performance. A silver and a gold each for the Averina twins.
Gymnast
being congratulated by their presentation party. The celebrations can't go on too long tonight. They will have to focus on the event again tomorrow. And there's a chance for two more apparatus finals and, of course, the opportunity to qualify for the all-around event.
Arina Averina, Dina Averina, Mediana Vladimova, il podio nella finale.
The smiles all around from medalists. Congratulating each other. And that all important photo being taken. They are identical twins. They've won identical medals, just in slightly different order. Congratulations extended to Neviana Vladinova from Bulgaria as well for her bronze medal. Now this time, that does conclude the victory ceremony and the action here at the Adriatic Arena. We hope you've enjoyed it. We'll join you back tomorrow for the clubs and the ribbon. That's all from us. Bye for now.
Signori, con questa cerimonia di premiazione si conclude la prima giornata della 35esima edizione dei campionati del mondo di ginnastica ritmica. L'appuntamento a domani con la seconda giornata che vedrà il programma di qualificazioni delle ginnaste individualiste con la rete e la. Signori, dal portato organizzatore, dalla Federazione Ginnastica e dalla Federazione Internazionale, un cordiale arrivederci a una felice serata.
Tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. We are now over also with the second final, that is final with ball exercise. In a few minutes we will be back with the official